Hey everybody, how's it going? Welcome back to Cosmic Culture, the channel where we talk about all major movie and television news, theories, breakdowns, and much, much more. The Suicide Squad has released, and we did a full review with spoilers yesterday, so feel free to check it out. Today, we're going to be talking about the two post-credit scenes and what exactly they mean moving forward. One of which, James Gunn himself has already come out and explained what it has to do with future stories. So we're going to talk about both of those. Let me know what you guys thought about the movie in the comment section down below. I'm seeing a lot of split feelings. A lot of people who say best movie DC has come out with in a very long time, and other people who say it was kind of a rush job and it wasn't as funny as it was intended to be. So let me know where you fall on that and tell me why. I love interacting with you guys, so don't be shy. Also, before we jump in it, consider subscribing and turn on the notification bell so you don't miss any of our daily uploads. So, at the very end of the Suicide Squad, we get two post-credit scenes, and yes, there are spoilers moving forward, so if you haven't seen it yet, be sure to back out and come back after you have. However, the ending of Suicide Squad does end with a little bit of a twist, as we find out that the United States was actually involved in the capturing of Starro, and they sent him out to this island in order to keep him from being a United States issue. They continued to help with these studies and tests, and when this was discovered, Kinnerman's character obviously had a problem with that, since he's an actual military agent, an actual soldier, and to find out that the country he's been fighting for, and a country that keeps putting him in these very terrible situations, is actually the cause of all of this mess. So he wants to do the right thing and report this to the media because the people have the right to know, and then we find out why Peacemaker was hired to join the Suicide Squad. He was actually sent there specifically for the purpose of making sure those records never come to light. And if somebody, like Kinnerman's character, end up finding out, it's Peacemaker's job to silence them. Which, very sadly, and ultimately he does do, he ends up killing Joel Kinnerman's character, and he's on his way to kill Ratcatcher, who also finds out and watches the whole thing happen. And that's when Bloodsport drops down, sees it, and shoots John Cena's Peacemaker, and ultimately kills him. Or so we think. And that's where we're left off. This character actually does kind of become a bit of a bad guy in the Suicide Squad who has alternative motives. And although you know what the right thing to do is here, and even he knows what the right thing to do is, and he says he regrets killing part of his team, but that's what he was assigned to do, and it's in the name of peace. And it is an ironic idea that this character has, that peace can be achieved by murdering as many people as possible, and it's all in the name of peace. And it's behind that liberty that he hides and decides to make the decision to kill members of his own team in order to complete the task that he was sent to do. So, very interesting little turn there, and it definitely left a lot of people a little cross with the character, and I think it put a lot of people off to the character, but there is a future for Peacemaker, as James Gunn is currently working on a series for Peacemaker, which I think is going to be very interesting because the character was very good. It was just kind of a weird turn at the end for him, as he ended up being kind of a bad guy on the team of bad guys. But that brings us to the post-credit scene. There are two of them. The first one is we find out that Weasel's not actually dead. We find out that he didn't drown in the first 3 minutes of the movie. He coughs, gets back to life, and runs off making all of his crazy weasel noises. Now, James Gunn himself hasn't actually explained what this might mean moving forward. However, it could possibly mean we might be getting a weasel movie, or if a second Suicide Squad movie, or I suppose a third now Suicide Squad movie, comes to be, Weasel can be involved again. And yes, James Gunn has been in talks with Warner Brothers to continue working with them. Warner Brothers put out a statement a week and a half, 2 weeks ago, saying they do have plans for James Gunn down the road. And I would imagine that is a continuation of the Suicide Squad that he's already started and created here, the sequel reboot that we got. So we'll follow in. And today on Twitter, he was even talking about how good of an idea a Suicide Squad versus Justice League movie would be. He said there's no work being done on that right now, but it would be a really cool idea. And I think eventually we will have to get the Suicide Squad versus the Justice League. I just think ultimately that'll be a lot of fun. And even though it will be a Batman versus Superman or a Kong versus Godzilla scenario where they'll end up teaming up at the end, who knows, James Gunn might throw in a lot of cool curveballs and actually kill Superman. How crazy would that be? But on that note, also we have the other post-credit scene, which is Peacemaker in the hospital, and it turns out he's not actually dead, which I think a lot of people figured was coming because this new series with Peacemaker wasn't a secret. I suppose when he died originally, I thought, okay, maybe it's a prequel series that leads up to him getting recruited in. We see all of those cool details, but it turns out it's not. It's a post this movie, and James Gunn even said he saw this movie as more of a prequel for this character. So we don't have to go back and explain who he is and what he does. So it sounds like in the actual series, it doesn't necessarily explain all of the things we've learned already about him, because this is his prequel, this is his beginning, and it'll be interesting to see what his character development is moving forward. Now, James Gunn does explain, as I said, a little bit about this and what we can be expecting and what we should be looking for from this prequel. And he explains it this way. I thought of it as a prequel, and at the end of the day, I'm like, I hate prequels, so I just wanted to continue to tell his story. And I thought that I wasn't really interested in seeing who Peacemaker was before all of this, because he's a real piece of work. A lot of the other characters got really deep changes in this movie, where they become much different people by the end of the situation than from beforehand, whereas Peacemaker doesn't. He actually becomes a little worse. And that's where we're going to pick up when we do get to the Peacemaker series, because it will be a lot of fun to watch his character now develop. You think about what James Gunn just said, King Shark changed as he was lonely and didn't trust anybody, but finally got some friends and became a really strong character. You talk about Bloodsport, who hated everybody, doesn't want anything to do with anything, including his own daughter, but ultimately becomes a huge leader and makes a lot of the right decisions throughout the movie. Ratcatcher, who lives up to her dreams and her potential, and all of the other characters who actually managed to survive, apart from maybe Weasel, all had really cool character turnarounds. Even characters we've seen for a while, like Harley Quinn, who made some big personal decisions in the film. And then we have John Cena's Peacemaker, who ultimately just became worse, or was bad the whole time, but was revealed to be even worse as the movie went on, which left a lot of people kind of angry with the character, and I don't know how that's going to bode for the series when it comes out about Peacemaker, because you got to have excitement to watch this character. However, I do think the character was fantastic. I thought he was funny. I thought he had a lot of cool, different ideas, morals, and abilities. So I can't wait to actually see what this series does for him, as this will be where he gets his character development. Whether he becomes better or worse, that'll be up to James Gunn. And even he's saying that he has been absolutely loving putting together this TV show. Now, this TV show does not have an official release date, but it was expected to come out in January 2022. So not too far away, but we'll have to wait to see if that sticks. A lot of release dates are still getting pushed around, but maybe because it is actually a TV show, it shouldn't really have an issue meeting those release dates. But overall, the movie was, in my opinion, pretty good, very enjoyable, definitely worth giving a watch. And I'd love to hear what you guys thought about these two post-credit scenes as well. Are you looking forward to Peacemaker? Do you hate the character now because of what he did? Or do you hope that there's a redemption arc in his series coming next year? Let me know in the comment section down below. As always, thank you to everybody who watched till the very end of the video. If you found it helpful, useful, or entertaining, be sure to subscribe and turn on that notification bell so you don't miss any of our daily uploads right here on Cosmic Culture.